I am a dynamic figure. I'm witty. I'm humorous like no one ever is. And everything I said so far isn't true. Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters. I call myself Deepak Albert, and here is a brief story of my life so far. With all the trouble the doctors took to pull me out of my mother's womb, I was born on 8th March, just like my sister. Yes, you heard me right. We're 5 years apart, but we're born on the same day. I always ask my parents, how did you plan all this? My dad goes like, I'm a Kalaveda, and my mom standing there and giving him the death stare. With all the hopes of getting a second girl child, they were gifted with something better, a blessing, me. Yay. Well, not really. They were at least happy I was born on Women's Day. I was a naughty child, and my parents didn't have any trouble finding me because the only place I would be found was at a shoe rack, biting away the shoes of our guests and relatives. 2 years down the lane, I was the same naughty child, no more interested in biting shoes anymore, attending my first day of school. I was excited. Probably more excited than my parents ever were because they knew what I was capable of. So my dad and my sister dropped me off to school, I bid them a goodbye, and I entered the class. I was a little late, but the orchestra had already begun. 60 kids crying so loud, and I was standing there wondering what on earth is wrong with these people. My teacher, assuming that I was a brave one, made me sit in the center of the class. Well, I couldn't resist. I joined the party. And the teacher had trouble controlling me more than all 60 students together. Fast forward 10 years and I'm in high school. High school is a big upgrade, from wearing shorts to wearing pants, it indeed was a big upgrade. But adding to the cons, we were with people whom we never spoke to. But life goes on. We got to know each other and continued to be the same old naughty kids. There are instances when we were caught copying in class and even made a teacher cry, but we were kids then, right? Couple of years down and I'm giving my 10th exam. I don't know if it's just me or everyone else, time goes real slow during examinations. I did good in my 10th, I took up bio, I did great in that too. With all this, I was just a normal child who was doing what everyone else did. School, college, medicine, or engineering. Well, I took the easiest way of engineering. 1 year into engineering, like every other engineering student ever realizes, even I felt, what the hell am I doing here? Is this really where I belong? Life finally decided to put a question mark in my head, finally. During this phase, like a person without a goal, I was just wandering away when I came across a motivational video. I didn't believe in the phrase, words can move a soul until then. I became glued to these videos, and this is where my interest for public speaking actually came. One such video introduced me to this person called Mr. Y. Mr. Y is an ambitious guy. He's full of gratitude. He's loving, caring, and moreover, he has a purpose in life. He has been my best friend ever since. We make sure we talk every single day. He's been through my ups and downs, and he's given me a purpose in life. You all might be wondering who Mr. Y is, right? Is he a human? No. Is he an alien? Yeah. Is he a Casper in my life? Well, maybe. But when I said Mr. Y of my life, I was referring to the Y of my life. Why can't I do it? Why shouldn't I do it? This single word has given me opportunity to look at the world in a different way. Given me hopes that I can always achieve what I've dreamt of. Yes, I was a little late in realizing that I didn't know what to do with my life. I took up engineering when my interest was bio. But like the saying goes, or more like my saying goes, when life doesn't give you a lemonade, you find your lemons and make a lemonade out of it. And with this attitude of mine, I've done great in my life. From taking up engineering to doing good at it, from being a 45 kgs chronic kid to becoming fit, and finding my ways to speak better on stage and off stage, I've done great in my life. Yes, it doesn't always guarantee that I'll be successful, but I know when I'm put down, Mr. Y has got my back. To everyone out here, I'd like to say, find the Y in your life. Try to be a better person than you were yesterday. With this said, please don't forget to have fun. Thank you.